Facebook says it's uncovered dozens of pages designed to meddle in the upcoming U.S. midterm elections. Some are calling it an influence campaign. So who was behind it and how did Facebook uncover it? For those answers, we're joined by CBC News senior technology reporter Matthew Braga. So who were these accounts and pages created by, and what was their purpose, Matthew?
So these pages, if you remember sort of in the run-up to the 2016 U.S. election and in the aftermath of that, we saw a lot of these hyper-partisan pages, these hyper-political pages, clearly designed to be divisive around sort of hot topic issues of gender, of race, of guns rights, of all sorts of things that the U.S. was grappling with at the time. The pages that Facebook has highlighted this week aren't quite to that extent. They're almost more nebulous, more subtle in the way that they've been designed. They still sort of deal with, there was one page that was a feminist page called Resistor. There was another one called Black Elevation. There was one that was targeted at Mexican Americans, but didn't have the same sort of really kind of like hyper-partisan sort of rhetoric as we saw in the past. And so clearly still designed to sort of hit upon some of those sort of hot button issues that we saw, but in a more subtle way, which actually makes it harder to identify as something that's even being used to influence in the first place.
How would an average Facebook user be able to identify them?
It's really, really difficult. I mean, even in Facebook's case, right, the only way in which they were able to identify these pages as being part of some, they call it a coordinated inauthentic behavior. It's basically Facebook speak for this sort of influence campaign that they've identified. And they found one piece of evidence linking it to some of the prior campaigns that they saw in the past. But if they hadn't found that, you know, you look at these pages and they look like so many of the other kind of just random pages that have popped up over the past couple of months, couple of years, people setting up sort of groups that are trying to resist the far right, people setting up Black Lives Matter-esque sort of activist groups, groups that sort of rally around specific causes. They very much fit into that mind. I mean, there's even interesting, one of the pages was called Mindful Being, and you look at it and it has all these like weird posts about unlocking your full potential and cosmos and, you know, kind of big galaxy brains. And you'd look at that and you'd go like, there's no chance that this could possibly be an influence campaign, but the whole idea is to kind of subtly introduce these ideas of sort of different thought and radical thought and then kind of use that to eventually influence and divide.
And it sounds like Facebook just got lucky then to find those other sites that were linked to the previous ones. They haven't actually found the source of this information, right?
No, so one of the interesting things about this particular case, so in the fall of 2017, they were able to actually pinpoint a bunch of the activity they saw in the run-up to the 2016 U.S. election and the months following to it's commonly called a Russian troll group, an organization called the Internet Research Agency, or the IRA. In that case, they were able to find some pretty definitive links, right? The people who were using these accounts were accessing their accounts and pages from Russian IP addresses. In some cases, they were paying for their ads in rubles. There were all of these things that that linked back to this. Even some of the posts, right, were clearly run through Google Translate in a way that suggested non-native English speakers. In this particular case, it's interesting. They haven't been able to see a lot of those same sort of hallmarks, those same trademarks. Facebook points to the fact that clearly the group behind this, while there's some similarities in tools, techniques, and behaviors with the IRA, they've done more to cover their tracks. They're not seeing Russian IP addresses. They're seeing ads actually bought in U.S. Canadian dollars in this case, rather than perhaps more suspect currencies. Even though there was one little bit of evidence, so there was an administrator who ran one of these pages who was actually a known sort of IRA account to Facebook, they say that this wasn't enough of a link to definitively pin this on Russia or the IRA.
All right, Matthew, thank you for this.
Thanks for having me.